Hi, I'm Wade from Thoroughbred Diesel, and today we're going to be installing a BD boost builder on a Ford 6.0 Power Stroke. The BD boost builder for the 6.0 Power Stroke, what is this going to do for your truck? So this is a really, really nice product from BD, and they went a little bit above and beyond and went outside of the normal thinking of the boost fooler products. So what is this going to do? The boost builder from BD, it actually integrates with the throttle position sensor, so it takes it one step farther. So you're getting that signal coming from your throttle position that's going to relay back to this boost builder that's going to get you even better low end power of the truck. So you're going to get quicker with the BD boost builder, you're going to get quicker turbo spool up, less turbo lag. This is actually going to eliminate the over boost code if you have that inside of your truck. Just a really, really good product, less than $100. Really good stuff. So we're going to go ahead and get started with our installation. Real quick and easy installation on this one. We will be making a splice into the ECM. So remember, always kids, start out with removing your negative battery cables. The MAP sensor on the 6.0 Power Strokes is going to be located on the passenger side of the truck. And you can see it right here. It is on this metal shelf that's got three bolts that holds it into the HVAC control. What we're going to do is we're going to remove that so you can actually see the connector. It's not necessary to remove it. However, it will be easier for you guys to see if we do. So there's three 10 metric bolts here. It's easier to get to the clip on the sensor too if you remove it. So I'm going to lift this plate off here so you can see the MAP sensor better and see the connector a little bit better. Be real careful. You've got a rubber hose here that's attached to a nipple on the MAP sensor. You can break that nipple off. If the truck's older, it's a little bit more brittle. So you just slide your red safety or your red clip down and then unhook your stock wiring harness. Remember not to put too much pressure on that hose. You can break the nipple off the MAP sensor and then it gets real expensive. So I just go right back to my BD boost builder. So male to female here on the stock harness, push it till it clips like that and close our connector. And then this is the yellow wire that reports back to the ECM for your throttle position. We're just gonna lay it out of the way here. Then we're going right back to the MAP sensor, just like this. Our new clip does not have a safety connection on it there. There we go. So there's the boost builder installed there. So we're going to lay the plate back down here and then we're going to bolt it back down. So our BD boost builder attached over here, what we'll do is we'll zip tie this up to try to get any loose ends tied up, but you do have your wire that will be reporting to you for throttle position sensor. It's just going to need to run along the cowl here. So we're running along the cowl and we're trying to get over to the ECM there on the driver's side fender well. So we're at the driver's side of the truck now and we're going to be going for the PCM connection now. So first off, what I did was I took the battery out so you could see. If you take the battery out of the driver's side, it really makes this job a whole lot easier. So what I want to do now is I just want to show you pulling the plug out of the ECM, which plug to get, and the wire that you're working for. So when you're dealing with the ECM plugs on these trucks, or the PCM plugs on these trucks, in the very center of it there's a latch, and all you do to disconnect it is push backward on the latch, and that's going to make this, I call these bail trips, but it's going to make that bail trip automatically go backwards as you push on it. As you're pushing the bail trip back, make sure you put a finger on both sides of it because they can be old and brittle and they can break on you, and you don't want that. You won't have good seating of the plug, so it could cause you tons of electrical issues. Thumb on both sides of it, continue to push back, and as you push back, it's going to roll the plug out itself. Now, at this point, what you want to do is you want to bring your bail trip back, not too far, don't take it over the back over the end, and I'm going to take this cap off of the wires, and I suggest that you do it too. The reason why you take the cap off of these wires is so you can see directly the pin that you're looking for So I'll just take something and just pop the cap off like that. Okay. There's two connections here, and then there's two connections on the bottom of it. All right, so we'll just go ahead and try to not drop our tool. We'll roll those connections out there. And of course, as I did it, guess what? The top went back. All right. So that just takes that backing plate off there. And now you've got good exposure to your wires. Okay. So you're looking for pin 37. This is the same connector from 03 to 04 trucks, 5 to 7 trucks. Okay. And the pin out that you're going to be looking for is the same. So here is the connector. And here's the connector as you look at it with the bell trip at the top. You're looking for pin number 37, which is the bottom row from the right of the connector looking at it. It's the second one from the right. Okay, so that's pin 37. For your 03 to 04 trucks, you're looking at a yellow wire. 05 to 07 trucks, you're looking at a white wire. So this is a 6, so we're looking for a white wire here. All right, so to dig that wire out, I know I'm on the bottom row, second pin over here. I can see there's a dingy white wire. The reason why this is important, and I've showed you this, is you can look through this loom. There's a white wire there. I think there might even be another one in there. If not, it doesn't matter. There's two white wires, okay? You can grab the wrong wire in this. So you definitely need to make sure that you take this apart and find the wire that you're looking for. Again, we're on pin 37, bottom row, second from the right. You can see there's a dingy white wire right there in the connector. And what I do is I just like to take, this is an O-ring tool, and it is all the edges on it are very, very dull, so it's not gonna cut anything. When I'm working through looms, I'm usually working with this. It's just easier for me. So there's my white wire. I've traced it back. Here, we're gonna be using a Posi-Tap for this connection. So I just kind of like to mark it with my little loom tool here. And I'll turn the connector the other way so it loosens up the wires, and then that gives me some room to work. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and install our Posi-Tap for our wire here. So what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna remove the black end of the Posi-Tap. And we've kinda got everything laid out where it's good and loose here from the connector. We're just gonna take the black end and just go ahead and engage it over the wire, slip it over the wire here to get ready for the Posi-Tap itself. Then I don't like to have my wire hooked up to this, that wire that's going to it, because I like to have full rotation of this so I can have a good, so I know that it penetrates the wire that I'm working on well. I'm actually gonna give us a little bit more light there. Give us a little bit more light on the subject. All right, so I've got my Posi-Tap started, so I'm just gonna run it down. Snug it down, and there we go. If you wanna check that, you can do key on, engine off, and check this side of it. You should have 1.5 volts will tell you that you've made a good tap there. So, that being done, now we're going to go ahead and bring our wire in from the boost builder. So we've run our wire from our BD boost builder. I like to run it along the main wiring harness there. I'll get everything zip tied up here in just a second. But we're gonna go ahead and connect this to our Posi-Tap. So you want to remove the red end of the Posi-Tap, and you're gonna wanna go ahead and slide it over the wire that you are connecting to the Posi-Tap, with the threads going towards the Posi-Tap. I like to trim just a little bit more back. It didn't have very much stripped off of it when you get it, which is fine. I just like to do just a little bit more. I'll kind of trim that up there. I take just a little bit more of the sheath off of it, and then you'll just go ahead and take this wire, and you want to go ahead and put as much of it in there as you can, so that you're not going to have any copper exposed out side of the posi tap so you don't have any short circuits. That you sure don't want this when working with an ECM connection, and tighten her back down. So we're good to go there. All right, so now we're ready to put everything back together. What I like to do here is I just want to kind of flip this back over the wiring harness, and I'm going to turn my wiring harness back into its natural position. And when you do that, what it does is it turns your wires and tightens them back up. So at this point, we'll put our cap back on it. That and the bottoms. All right. You want your bell trip pushed back like so. And then you're going to go ahead and re-engage it into the ECM. So the bell trip needs to be all the way back. Re-engage it into the PCM there and push it and tighten it. Set it back down there. Your connection, you'll just want to make sure that this is clear of everything and that you can push this down, keep it out of the way. I try to keep it out of the way as best I can so nothing's gonna, you know, grab it, pull it, and jerk it out of the connection there. So we'll keep all of the tag in zip tied up there, keep it from having any contact with anything. So we've got everything in our engine bay cleaned up. I've already got my battery cables on. My PCM connection is done that we showed you over there. I just ran, you know, like we were talking about, just ran my APPS wire across the engine cowl, and then I zip tied it up through the wiring harness going to the driver's side. Then I've just got the BD Boost Builder here to where it's kind of up and out of the way. So we're gonna go ahead and take her for a test drive and see how she does. All right, so we've got our BD Boost Builder installed on our 0660 truck, and I'm just gonna go ahead and tell you, on our first test drive, I can tell a lot of difference in the turbo boost in the bottom end and the takeoff on the truck. It's not as laggy as it was. It was definitely a noticeable difference, which is nice in boost builders or boost foolers or whatever you want to call them. You know, they really are sometimes are a module that goes in there to just keep you from throwing an over boost light. It's nice to have a product like the BD Boost Builder that actually performs and something that you can really tell, you know, see the pants. So absolutely, BD Boost Builder, big thumbs up from us. Nice addition to this truck. So if you got a question about this installation or any of our other BD installs or any of our other products, just give us a call. As always, we really appreciate it if you like to subscribe to our channel, and thank you for watching.